Well, it says, why is this logo so jagged? I went to the website, it said, hey, DARPA, I want a nicer logo. And it said, well, at the time, DARPA's not able to provide such things. I was like, really? Wow, that kind of sucks. I thought this kind of thing was just like open, you know, like the government can get its own copyright, and get their own kind of thing. And in a law, 17 U.S. Code 105, as I'm sure you all know, and it said, subject matter is copyright, you guys have work, blah, 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 but by this time, you know, the logos aren't mentioned there. Yes, yeah, so I'm giving a talk about government logos. My career is really confusing. Well, basically, something not supposed to be, right? And the Joint Committee on Printing Power of the United States, they said, you know, logos aren't the same. But logos impart endorsements. They impart rulings in some ways. These two guys, Smile Chuck Schumer and Bob Matt Brady, one's from New York, one's from Kentucky or something. And they decided that logos should be protected. Right? People should be able to use the Department of Defense logo on a rig, right? And so, if you look around, you find some really interesting logos, like this America as a flag thing for the Take Pride in America program, which I'm sure you're all familiar with, right? Yeah? Okay. And the Department of Interior program about taking pride in America. Well, and if you look at it, really, it makes sense, though. You know, the Health and Human Services, for instance, you can't just take their logo, put it on, you know, magical magnet water and tell everyone to tell people. Right? Because the government's all cool with that, because we're all five people and stuff. And so they didn't want to use this really bitchin' logo they made on those products. Actually, I'm serious, this is a really cool logo. It's actually children on it, it's got a flag and an eagle thing going on here. This is the logo that people want to feel, right? Now, and then these logos. Smokey Bear, not Smokey the Bear. Don't screw it up. There's like cops who care about this. And he has no Pantone listing, too. It's serious shit. Anyway, so it protects us, right? But Pepino, sorry, NASA photos, however, are yours to use as you please. Pictures of space, often mostly pictures of Earth, yours to use. The NASA logo, called the meatball, by the NASA guys, not a good use. Can't again use that as an endorsement. I have to find it on the Portuguese website. Icons have their own photo for, and all those photos are free to use. You can do basically whatever you want with them. And in fact, if you as a visitor to the website upload something, you're saying we can all use it on the Creative Commons by attribution license. Woo. That's pretty nice. So I found a picture, I thought I'd share it with you. You know, we're here to talk. He's really good guy. And you know, they're talking, and you know, the picture here, the gut. This is real, man. I didn't talk to this at all. But wait a second, isn't the flag a logo? No. The flag is not a logo. It's especially protected by its own law, and they have criminal-like penalties for screwing up the flag. But they were struck down by the Supreme Court, and they added the PWMIA flag to it, and it's pretty neat. In fact, the letter CIA have more protection than the flag does, which is pretty interesting if you're crazy about the flag, I guess, right? Literally, you can't use CIA in any sort of endorsement or advertising capacity, which I think makes all this common sense look completely ridiculous. So remember, it's up to all of you to change this if you want, or not, for now, for the rest of your life. And only you can prevent forest fires. And then smoky is the proper coloring and the rest. And that's a proper slogan.